guys, what's up? I hope all of you are doing fine and welcome back to my channel. So today I am in Bandra and I am in Bandra because I am come to shoot and I have noticed that many people have taken interest in terms of how I shoot my photos on Instagram and how I edit them. So today I am here in Bandra to click some photos. So I decided I'll vlog and show you guys that how I shoot my pictures and how I edit them and upload them on Instagram. So today my location for shoot is in Bandra and we are come to Carter Road where Debu rehta and we really miss him. And my photographer is also here, Mr. Nikhil. He always does my photo shoot and aaj bhi he's only gonna do my photo shoot because I trust his photography more than anybody else's and I did not seem to find a good photographer yet, sadly. First thing that is important when it comes to shooting your photographs is location. And Malad mein sari locations mein shoot karke ho gaya aur Malad mein there are not so many colorful walls or walls that have graffiti. So that's why I decided to come to Bandra today. And my first location is this wall at Carter Road which has like a good graffiti painting on it. And I think that it's a really good option to click your photos and makes a very good background. Lions roaring in the morning sun, searching for a longer day. People feeling like the light has just come. We must never stop the way. Yeah. Birds chirping and I hear my name. So we are done shooting at the first location. I got better pictures than I expected and I even clicked some of Nikhil's pictures here because he kabhi bhi apne photos nahi khichta hai.
Hum video nikalte hain.
But finally I'm happy that we have pictures for him also. And this location is really good in terms of that it has this really nice graffiti wall and it has this purple color painted boat and we even made use of this wall. So done with the first location. Life is happy but it's so insane. We must merely make a start. So I found location number 2. We thought we go really behind, like really close to Mount Mary. Lekin ye wala location mujhe bahut zyada pasand aaya. It's like a staircase and it again has graffiti painted on it. A very good location. So I'm planning to take my second picture here. I'm so happy that I found one because we're very close to sunset and I'm glad that we found a good location so soon. We have this location pe aaye and we're already done clicking pictures and again I got really good pictures. I mean Nikhil clicks pictures really well and really so fast. So I'm really happy that we are done with the second location too. And now we just need to find the third spot and I am done. So if you guys are looking for a second option to click your photos in Bandra, I think this staircase is again a very good option for you guys to come and click your photos. So I'm climbing up the stairs because Nikhil wants to take a time lapse of the sunset from here. So when you climb up the stairs, you come onto the road that's very close to Mount Mary Church and there he already reached. But I'm still reaching. Yeah. So there he is. Birds have just begun. We will always take a stand for the people. We have now come to the last location for the day and it is Bandstand. And we've come here because Nikhil wants to take a time lapse and I thought why not take a good scenery picture here and show you guys how I edit my scenery pictures for Instagram and also a picture in low light because the sun has set, almost set. So maine socha I will also take a photo in low light area here and show you guys how you can edit and make your pictures look good even if they are taken in low light. Let's go back to when we were young. For the animals we stand. Let's go back to when trees. We are done shooting and clicking all the pictures that I wanted to shoot, and they came out quite well, and now I cannot wait to edit and show you guys how it's done. And thanks to Nikhil, I mean, he helped me so much in taking my pictures like the way I wanted to. And Nikhil ka bhi kaam ho gaya,
bhi kaam ho gaya na, phir
kahin bhi kaam ho jata hai aajkal, wo time gaya abhi ki specific jagah jana padega.
So Nikhil, I want to ask you a question. You've been clicking my pictures from a very long time. So what do you think is important when it comes to clicking pictures for Instagram?
For Instagram?
Yeah.
First is attitude. Like, how are you posing? Because the attitude is wrong, because sometimes you have noticed that when you're posing, you're not comfortable. You're very shy. So the attitude matters. So if you're shy, it will not come nice. And the second thing matters is the location. Location is very important. So attitude, then location.
Lighting, I think you're forgetting lighting. Lighting,
yeah,
conditions.
Lighting conditions. And I don't need to say, I'm pretty sure most of you know, but then the best time to click pictures is sunrise, while 1 hour after the sunrise. I mean, sunrise se lekar ek ghanta, and then during the sunset. Because if this is object, sunlight yahan par hoga ya phir yahan par hoga. If you'll take around like anywhere between 11 to 2, then sun upar hota hai. और आपका शेडोज जो है आपकी यहाँ गिरता है, देन यू नीड रिफ्लेक्टर्स. और अगर आप ऐसा रोड पे ऐसा रिफ्लेक्टर लेके घूमोगे तो इट्स नॉट रियली नाइस.
सो अभी हमारा शूट करके हो गया है, नाउ वी विल चिल अ बिट, आई मीन हैव समथिंग टू ड्रिंक और ईट, एंड देन आई एम गोना गो होम, निकिल्स गोना गो होम, एंड आई एम गोना शो यू गाइस हाउ इट्स एडिटेड. Also, when it comes to clicking good pictures for whatever purpose that is, अगर आपका कैमरा अच्छा ना हो या आप जिस डिवाइस से अपने फोटोज ले रहे हो अगर वो अच्छी क्वालिटी का ना हो, then automatically your pictures will not look good. That is why it's very important that the camera that you use for clicking your pictures is a good camera. So for me, the devices that I use to click my pictures for Instagram is 80D mostly when I need to take pictures for my work. So I use the 80D Canon. Other than that, I use the G7X Mark II Canon again, and I'm even shooting my video with that now, and it takes amazing pictures as well. So I really love that about this camera. The third device that I use is my iPhone 6, and I really like taking pictures from iPhone 2 because it takes really, really good pictures. And while you're using your iPhone to click pictures, if you use the HDR mode, it takes pictures more better. That's what I do. Whenever I click pictures from my iPhone, I always use the HDR mode. Now coming to the editing part. To edit my photos, I use 3 different apps. First one is Lightroom. I use Lightroom because Lightroom can be really useful when you have pictures that are shot in low light areas, or pictures that are really dark and you want to brighten them up. Lightroom plays a big role in making your pictures look like they were clicked in good lighting. Then the second app that I use is Snapseed. Now Snapseed has a lot of features. If you want your photos to look really colorful and bright and really nice, I think Snapseed is a very good option. And the third app that I use is Visco. And why I like Visco so much is because if you want to give your pictures that Instagrammy look, I mean Visco is the perfect app. So I use a mixture of all three depending on whatever feel I want to give my photographs, and I use the app accordingly. So I'm going to show you guys all the three apps so that you all know exactly which app I'm talking about. And these apps are available on Play Store and App Store both. So if you have an Android phone and iPhone as well, these apps are available for both. So here is Lightroom and here is Snapseed, and this is how the logo of Lightroom looks. It's Adobe Photoshop Lightroom, and this is the mobile phone version. And this is how the logo for Snapseed looks. And this is how the app for Visco looks. So this is the one that you have to download for Visco. So yesterday I took all these photographs, and I'm going to show you now by selecting some of the pictures that I've clicked on different locations and use which app to edit these. So now I'm planning to edit this photo first. So now I'm going to quickly show you how I'm going to edit this. First, I'm going to go to Visco, and I'm going to get this photo. Now that the photo is selected, you go on this option down here and you edit it like this. So here is the photo. Also on Visco, out of all the filters that they have, the A filters, that is A4, A5 and A6, and The HB1 and HB2 filters are my favorite filters because I like giving my photos a cool tone. So that's the reason I like these filters. So I'm quickly gonna like try out all the filters and see which one looks the best. A5 is too dark, A6 is a little too yellow tone, and this is HB1 and this is HB2. I think HB1 looks the best, so I'm gonna go with this one, and I'm gonna adjust the temperature as much as I want to. Okay, this much is fine, so right. After that, I go to the different features that this has. So I click on the second icon on the screen. And here you have all the different features as exposure, contrast, strength in crop and all of that. Since I do not want the full length of the picture, I'm gonna crop it to this much. So I want to adjust the exposure a bit, so. After that, I go on to sharpen the image because I want the clarity to look better, so I will adjust the sharpening. Yep, this is it. After that, I'll go and adjust the saturation a bit. Yeah, this is it. After that, I go on to, because I like to add a cool tint to my pictures and I really like the purple kind of finish, so I go on to the last option, that is the shadows tint, the second last option actually, shadows tint, and I go and select the purple thing, so it has a purple hue to the entire photo. Then I go and adjust it and reduce it as much as I want to. Yeah, this is it. And then I just go and click on save. And from here, if you want to save your photo to your phone, you go to this three dots here at the end and you select it and you go to save to camera roll and you say actual size and your photo is saved. Second photo that I want to edit is again clicked on the first location, and this is the photo that I clicked of Nikhil's, and I'm going to edit this photograph now. Visco again, and I'll go to add photos by clicking on the plus sign. And come down and select Nikhil's photograph, the one that I liked. Here it is. And press on right. After that, I go back to this option here. And accordingly, again, I'm gonna go and select which filter I like. I always select A filters or either the H filters, HB filters. So I'm gonna go and try out the A filter. No, not this one. Not this one either. I like the HB1 for this picture, so I'm gonna select this and adjust it to the level that I want to. Yeah, this is it. After that, I'll go to the other features that they have and go and adjust the exposure first. That is it. After that, I go on to sharpen. That is it. Then I'll go on to saturation and select as much as I want to. This is it. And after that, the last thing that I do is go to the second last option and select shadows tint. Get the purple tint here and adjust it according to the level I want to. Yeah, this is it. And then I'm going to press on right and save. And from here, I go on to save it to camera roll, actual size. So this is the pattern that I follow while editing my photos on Visco. Now that it's saved to my camera roll, I'll go to Snapseed because I'm not done editing that photo. I'll go to Snapseed and I'll click on open. Open from device. And I'll select the first photo that I just edited on Visco. And from here I'll go on, so here they have a lot of filters that you want to select, but I never select filters on Snapseed. I think Visco has better filters when it comes to Instagram. Then I go on to tools here, and my favorite tool out of here is brush. On this you can adjust the exposure, the temperature and the saturation. So here I want to add a little more color to this picture and make Nikhil's face look a little more glowy. So what I do is I will go to saturation, and it's plus 10, so I'll go down and make it to plus 5, and then you just take your fingers and brush like that. So that's how you increase the color and the saturation of the background. Now that the saturation of the background is increased, I'll go and click right again. After that, I'll go on tools again, I'll go to brush once more, and then I'll go to exposure. I'll come to 0.3, and then I'll just go across Nikhil's face and brighten him up. And that's it. I think my photo looks good now, so I'm just gonna click on the right button and do export and save a copy, and there it is, saved. So now this is the photo that I clicked on the second location. Then I'm going to edit this photo now. Visco first, add the photo. Here it is. Press on the right sign. Select it. Go to the second option on Visco and edit it. So you know the drill now. I'll go to the filters. A4, no. A5 is a little too dark. A6. So before I go on and actually select a filter or finalize a filter, I go and try out from the ones that I like. Now I'll try the HB1 and the HB2. I like the HB2, so I'm gonna try to adjust this. Yeah, so this is it. Then I'll go and press the right button. After this, I'll come to the other features that they have. Go and select the exposure. After that, I'll go on to sharpen, and I'll sharpen it as much as I want to. This is it. So right, then I'll go to saturation, and I'll adjust the saturation as much as I want to, and just click right. After that, I'll go on to the last thing that I do is add the purple tint. You can select whatever tint you want to. Okay, there is purple tint, there is this pink tint, there is this yellow tint, there is this bright yellow tint, there is this green tint, and then there is this blue tint on Visco, out of which I honestly prefer the purple tint a lot. And then I just go and adjust it as much as I want to. Now that I'm done adjusting the tint, I go and click on right, and I'm done on Visco. So I'll quickly go and save it. Back to Snapseed because I'm not done. My face looks quite dark in this picture, so I will go to, so also Snapseed always opens up the last picture that you have edited on it. I'm gonna go and select the latest photo that I just edited on Visco. Here it is. So now I just want to adjust the tone on my face because it's too dark. So I'm gonna go to tools, go to brush, just go to exposure. So exposure has 0.7 and 0.3. if you select 0.7, it's like too bright, it spoils the photograph. And even if you've done this by mistakenly, you can always go down and select eraser and then just go over your face, and you will unedit your face. So then I'll go to 0.3, and now I'll just brush across my face, I'll brush across my hands, and that's it. I'm quite happy with the way it looks. What do you guys think? And I'm done. So this is the last picture that I'm going to show you guys by editing. This is the picture I clicked on my last location, that was Bandra Bandstand. And as you can see that this photo has a little less of light now. So now I'm going to use Lightroom in case of this photo. Here it is. From here, there is an option called as camera roll. Okay. And I would quickly go to the photo that I want to edit. Here it is. So over here, they have many different options right down, so you can select whichever one you want to. And the desktop version of Lightroom is better, but since I like editing my photos on Instagram quite quickly, I like to use it on my phone. So over here, since I want to increase the brightness of this photograph, I'll go to light, and here I'll go to exposure, and this is it. Then I'll go to blacks and I'll go and reduce it. And I'm done what I had to do on Lightroom, so I'll go and click right. The photo that you've just edited on Lightroom will always be on top in your Lightroom photos, and you're gonna go and click on this icon and do save to camera roll, maximum available, and I'm done. Now I want to add some color to my photograph, so I'll go to Snapseed and I'll just open the photograph that I just edited on Lightroom. Now I'm going to quickly select the tools. Brush is my favorite, like I just said. And I'm going to go to temperature, and it's plus 10. So I'm going to go to minus 10. So okay, when you use plus 5 and plus 10, it gives more of a warm tone. And if you go to minus 5 and minus 10, it adds a blue tone. So since I want the water to look a little bit blue, so I went to minus 10. And I'm going to select the water quickly. And that's how I'll be able to give it a blue tint, and the sky as well. So I'll go and click right. I'll go to this option again, brush, and I'll go to saturation, and I'll go to plus 5, and I'm going to brush across this place here to add more color to the photograph. After this, I'm going to take the tool sign again and go to brush and go to exposure and select 0.3 and just go over my face and all over my body so I can highlight myself in the picture, and then click right. And since I want to crop the image because there is like extra background here, so I'm going to go to click crop and just get this as much as I want to and adjust it. So this is it, and go right, and that's it. I love how the picture looks now, and that is it, guys. I mean, this is how I edit my pictures, and I hope that it was helpful for you guys to know how I edit my pictures. And if you are new to editing photos and if you want your Instagram feed to look nice, I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you like the way that I edit my photographs. So please leave your comment down below saying how you find my editing skills, you know, which was your favorite photo out of the ones that I just edited and showed you guys. If you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button, to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Also guys, if you aren't following me on my social media like Instagram, please go and follow me. I'll be leaving my username right here for you guys so that you can follow me there. Don't forget to follow me there because I'm really like very regular there, so you'll get all the updates that you want to from me. Guys, the next video that's going to come out after 2 days after this video is going to be a video for girls, so please don't come for that video. Come back for the next video, that will be a vlog again. And if you have girlfriends, sisters or wives or whatever, so please ask all your girls to come and subscribe to my channel and see my next video because it is for them. So anyways, that was it. So take care of yourselves, be safe, and I will see you in my next video.